Hey everyone, so prom time is finally here, and way back when I was in high school, that was like one of the most exciting times of the year for me, and you know, me and my friends would just go all out for prom, and it was probably one of the most fun times back in high school. So I put together a prom look for you guys. I really hope you give it a try, try it out on your friends and all that. So this is what I came up with, and it's mostly a matte mixed with like a frosty sort of look, and I explained why in the tutorial, but it's usually like for picture purposes, because hopefully you take a lot of pictures during prom night, and if you do, you better send them to me because I want to see them. But anyway, this is the makeup look that I came up with for prom, and I hope you give it a try. So let's get started with the tutorial. So before we put on any eyeshadow on our eyes, we're going to be using a base, and this is just going to help your eyeshadow stay on throughout the night. You know, when you're dancing, you're sweating, you really want your eyeshadow to just stay on, and instead of it like, you know, running all over your face or getting like those raccoon eyes underneath. And notice on this eye how I didn't really put anything on the lower lash line. That's like for the purpose of, you know, when you get really hot, that stuff underneath there, underneath your eye, it tends to just smudge and run. So we're just going to keep it really simple on the lower lash line. Okay, so the base that I'm using is a cream eyeshadow, and this is Painterly Paint Pot. Before you put on a cream eyeshadow, I really recommend you use an actual primer, whether it's Laura Mercier Eye Basics or Urban Decay Primer Potion. This is what it looks like. And this is just really, really gonna lock in anything that you put on your eye. So I'm just gonna apply this all over the lid and a little bit on the lower lash line. Next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to pick up a dark matte color, and this is the color that we have right through here, and this is called Sign Sealed. It's from MAC, and the reason why I'm using a matte color is just because when you take pictures with your friends, with the flash photography, if you use a lot of shimmer, it can just all kind of like blend in together. So we're going to keep more of like the shimmery colors right here on the inner corner and keep the matte colors right out through here, just so there's like that nice contrast and the flash doesn't make everything like it looks like you have glitter like all over your eyes. So, okay, so we're gonna start off with this. I'm just gonna take a flat shader brush. So if you have anything similar to this, just go ahead and grab that. And then we're just going to place this on the eye, and then we're gonna blend it out in a little bit. So make sure to tap it off, especially if you've just done your foundation or your concealer. You don't really want those dark flecks of eyeshadows to fall into your cheeks. So we're going to start right here on the outer part of the lid, and I'm holding my brush in an angle like this. So, because notice how we have our eyeshadow kind of at an angle over on this eye. And so we're just going to kind of follow that shape and just keep adding on little by little. Now it's good to just, you know, add on, but also look back to your other eye to make sure that you're on the right track. And I'm bringing it up a little bit high, bring it up to however far you want to, whatever feels comfortable for you. Also, if you want to use like a green or a blue, just depending on what dress you're wearing, if you're wearing a green dress and maybe you want to match it up with your eyeshadow and you want like a dark, dark green, feel free to do that. You don't have to use these colors. Use whatever you already have in your current collection. And then if you want to take a little bit of a black shadow, right here I have MAC Carbon, and it's just a very flat matte black color. I'm going to take a little bit of that, and that's just going to help deepen up this color right here on the outer part of the eye. Just be really careful with it. And it's just going to deepen up that color and give it a little bit of dimension. And again, it's still matte, so it's not going to conflict too much with the color that we have placed. So I'm just going to keep going and keep blending it inward. Next, I'm gonna take a fluffier blending brush. This is the MAC 217. It's kind of tapered, so it gives you a little bit more control. I'm gonna pick up my eyeshadow again, and I'm just gonna start off from right here, like that middle part, and just kind of bring it over, just very, very lightly. And this is gonna help with the blending process, just so we don't have like a huge chunk of that darker color on the outer corner. So just keep blending it over. Also right up here at the top part, just be very mindful, I guess I could say, of the eyebrow shape that you have. So mine is a little bit more of like a sharper arch, so I'm just going to kind of follow the shape of my brow when I bring it over. And then right through here, just make sure that everything's nice and smooth. Now the next color I'm gonna use is a shimmery lilac color, and this is called Hypnotizing. I actually use this in my top 10 favorite MAC eyeshadows, and a lot of people ask me to put this in a tutorial. So anyway, it's just like a shimmery lilac color. It came out with a Lovelace collection, and I'm not sure if they still carry it anymore. But anyway, so I'm gonna take a different flat shader brush. So this guy is kind of like for my matte colors, and this one is for my shimmery colors, just to kind of keep those separate, and there's a nice contrast between the two. So I'm just gonna pick that up, and we're just gonna place this all over the lid, all over the inner part of the lid. And I'm gonna be very, very careful right here when I bring it further toward the matte colors, not to bring it too far in. So right where this line of separation is, just make sure that you just like lightly tap it, just so this darker matte part doesn't turn shimmery as well. Next, I'm gonna take a shimmery white color, and this is called Vanilla, and it's a pigment from MAC. If you have anything that's white and shimmery or silver and shimmery, go ahead and use that. And we're gonna pop that right here on the inner corner, and this is just gonna give us that really nice highlight and also give us like that nice transition from the lighter color, or the lightest color to the lighter and then to the dark. And so this is gonna be really, really pretty on any skin tone, for any makeup look, any dress. Just an idea, if you're wearing, like for example, if you're wearing like a green dress, maybe you want to be matchy, you can use like a dark green color right through here, and then maybe like a medium tone or a lighter green, and then you always use like a lighter color on the inner corner, and it just makes a huge difference, especially when you have like darker colors right out through here. Next, I'm going to take a matte highlight color, and I'm using Blink Type. Also from MAC. Again, if you don't have any of these colors, definitely use something that you have in your current collection that you feel is comparable. Just use what you already have. You don't have to go out and buy all this stuff for prom. Just use stuff that you already have. So I'm just putting that right underneath my brow. And again, if you have a matte color, that will work perfectly. If you don't, that's completely okay too. So we're just gonna take a blending brush and buff that out, just so there's no line of separation between the darker color and the highlight color. So it's just gonna be a real nice, soft transition between the two colors. Now I'm gonna take a liquid liner, and this is the L'Oreal Intense Liquid Liner. If you wanna use a pencil, go right ahead. Just make sure that it's one of those pencils that is kind of on the dry side and not too creamy, or else it will smudge throughout the night when you get all sweaty when you're dancing and stuff. So anyway, I'm just gonna line my upper lash line, and I'm also gonna wing it out. If you don't wanna wing it out, that's completely up to you. Whatever you wanna do is just, what it does is it just elongates the eye. So yeah, I'm just gonna make it a little bit thick right through here on the inner corner. And then as we get to the outer corner, we're gonna make it a little bit thicker. And then right through here, we're just gonna line that upward, flick it out, and then just connect that flick with our main line that we drew on our upper lash line. And then I'm gonna take a black eyeliner. This is pencil, so again, you know, if you have a pencil eyeliner that's a little bit creamy, you may wanna just use an eyeshadow and kind of smudge it in your lower lash line. This is Jordana Easy Liner for Eyes. You can get this at like Walgreens and any kind of drugstore. And this stays on pretty well. So what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna kind of find that line right up here, and then I'm gonna very, very lightly fill in my lower lash line, just so it doesn't look too disjointed, and it kind of completes the look a little bit more. I'm gonna take my finger and just smudge it out and put a little bit in my waterline, but I'm only gonna bring it to about right there. So notice how we don't have it all the way in on the other side. So it just gives more like the emphasis on the outer part of your eye. Okay, so now it's time for mascara. Definitely use a waterproof mascara. And if you wanna use false lashes, you can do that too. False lashes is just another thing that you kinda have to keep an eye on, especially if you're dancing and all of that. You don't wanna have to worry about your eyelashes popping off throughout the night. So I definitely recommend using a waterproof mascara. So I hope you have a wonderful, wonderful prom. Take lots of pictures. Be safe, and I will see you guys later. All right, bye.